In southwestern Kenya in 2018, a vast, violent crack opened up in the ground, extending for several kilometers. This massive tear was, in some sections, 50 feet deep and 50 feet wide. It sliced through the Nairobi-Narok Highway and split homes in two. Geologists were puzzled. The East African Rift Valley is a massive geological feature where two tectonic plates, the Somali and the Nubian, are slowly pulling away from each other. So, what caused this? Was this a local collapse caused by heavy rains and simple soil erosion, or was it something much larger? Dr. Lucia Pérez-Díaz, an earth scientist and geodynamicist, was one of the first to crack the puzzle. Her models showed that the crack was most likely the erosion of soft soils infilling an old rift-related fault. She explained the underlying mechanics. The region's ground is composed of weak volcanic soils. Recently, exceptionally heavy rainfall had saturated this soil. The water washed away the soft earth, causing the ground to collapse along a line of weakness. It is not the first time her models have cracked open a notoriously difficult puzzle. She is credited with creating one of the most comprehensive explanations of plate tectonics behind the formation of the Himalayas, solving a 60-million-year-old mystery. Pérez-Díaz is a scientist who sees the deep story beneath the surface. This is a journey through how she solved one of the greatest mysteries of geology. Lucia Pérez-Díaz is from Galicia, in northern Spain. She calls it a magical land. She is now based in Oxford, in the United Kingdom. She jokes that in the UK, it rains just as much. From an early age, she needed a creative outlet. She studied music and played the piano through her teens. She was also the student, always the one to be scolded for doodling in class. This was a lifelong habit. When she attended the Universidad de Oviedo in Spain, she faced a choice: geology or music. Ultimately, she was swayed by an influential earth systems teacher and chose geology, having been wary of the hustle required by a professional career in music. That choice led her to the UK for a master's degree in structural geology and tectonics. It then led to a PhD in geodynamics at Royal Holloway, University of London. For her doctorate, she focused on modeling the opening of the South Atlantic and how the ocean's shape evolved over time. Her early work earned notice. In 2018, she received the Geologists Association's Halsted Award, one of the most prestigious awards given for a substantial contribution at an early stage of a career. She describes her work in simple terms. She is a detective of sorts, and her most famous detective work solved the mystery of the largest mountains on Earth. To understand our planet, one must accept two principles. First, Earth's surface is constantly changing. This dynamic surface is composed of massive rock slabs, known as tectonic plates, which fit together like a colossal jigsaw puzzle. These plates are in perpetual, slow motion, drifting at about the same speed as human fingernails grow. This deliberate movement is the force that shaped the world as we know it. About 60 million years ago, this process produced its masterpiece, the Indian microcontinent, which had spent eons as an island, finally plowed into Eurasia. The collision was agonizingly slow, but its force was relentless. The Eurasian landmass crumpled. Rock was forced upward, kilometer by kilometer, eventually creating the Himalayas. But the data showed a problem. When geologists ran tectonic time travel simulations, they saw something strange. The models, which reconstruct the past movements of plates, showed India behaving erratically. Around 67 million years ago, just before the collision, the Indian plate really picked up speed. It was as if it strapped on a jetpack, while other plates ambled along. This apparent acceleration was a major problem. It seemed to violate the known rules of plate tectonics. The main engine driving the plates is subduction. This is the process where one plate sinks into the deep mantle beneath another. This sinking has a natural speed limit, like the terminal velocity of a falling object. India was moving way faster than this known rate. Geologists devised the plume-push hypothesis to account for this discrepancy. This widely accepted theory proposed that a superheated fountain of material, known as the Réunion plume, must have risen from the deep mantle. This plume, the geologists posited, arrived beneath India and functioned as a hydraulic lift, causing the crust to dome. They suggested that this uplift essentially caused the Indian plate to slide downhill, resulting in its acceleration. Pérez-Díaz, like many others, found this behavior unusual and was skeptical of the plume-push hypothesis. She felt that the explanation was unconvincing. She decided to re-examine the evidence from scratch. Pérez-Díaz is a plate modeler, a geodynamicist. Her work is to build quantitative computer models that illustrate the planet's past. Invisible magnetic stripes on the ocean floor serve as crucial hints for her models. These stripes are recorded by ships and form at mid-ocean ridges where new seafloor is continuously generated. As magma rises and cools into rock, it incorporates tiny magnetic minerals. These minerals align with the Earth's magnetic field at that time, like miniature compass needles. Once the rock solidifies, this magnetic direction is permanently preserved or frozen in place. Over geologic time, the Earth's magnetic field reverses its polarity. The North Pole becomes the South Pole, and vice versa. The next band of new rock freezes in this new, reverse direction. This process repeats for eons. It creates a barcode-like pattern of normal and reversed polarity stripes on the seafloor. This barcode is the planet's clock. To know how fast a plate is moving, scientists use a simple equation. They measure the width of a stripe, which gives them the distance. They divide it by the duration of that magnetic period, which gives them the time. The result is the plate's speed. For this to work, everyone must trust the geological timescale that assigns official ages to each magnetic flip. Pérez-Díaz went back to the raw magnetic data. When she ran her models, she confirmed the observation. India showed a massive speed spike, but then she found something that was not supposed to be there. She looked at the Atlantic Ocean. It showed a big spike at the exact same time. She checked the ridge between India and Antarctica. It had a spike. She checked the ridge between Africa and Antarctica. It also had a spike. This was impossible. Tectonic plates form a closed system on the globe. There is no event that can make every single mid-ocean ridge on the planet speed up at the same time. If one plate accelerates, another must slow down to compensate. What she had found was a global glitch. The entire planet's tectonic system seemed to accelerate and decelerate in perfect, impossible synchrony. Her conclusion was startling. The problem was not the plates. The problem was the clock. The only explanation is that our timescale is wrong, she realized. The accepted timescale, the one everyone used, had miscalculated the ages of the magnetic flips around the Cretaceous-Paleogene boundary. The error was not small. Her calculation suggested the duration for that period was wrong by as much as 70%. Her 2020 paper, published in the journal Geology, laid out the case. Once the geological timescale was recalibrated with the corrected durations, India's dramatic acceleration vanished. It was an illusion created by a faulty clock. India had never strapped on a jetpack. It had been moving at a steady, predictable speed all along. Dr. Lucia leads a dual life. By day, she is a computational geodynamicist. By night, she is a freelance illustrator, known online as the Flat Type. She has moved from sketching doodles around the edges of notebooks to drawing with pixels. A big part of her career is her illustration work. She actually wrote and illustrated the kids' nonfiction book, How the Earth Works. The goal of the book is to explain the complex idea of plate tectonics in a way that's fun and easy to grasp for young readers, even those as young as 7. She is also the illustrator for Quaternary, an educational card game about the geological timescale funded by the European Geosciences Union. She drew all 60 cards, which depict key events from Earth's history, from the formation of the moon in the Hadean Aeon to the rise of humans. She believes that science is packed with awesome stories, and that art is a fantastic way to tell them. She points out that a lot of scientific reports and papers just get bogged down in everything. They're often too dense, hard to get into, and don't really get people excited. A good scientific visual must do 3 things. First, it must be accessible, even to people with colorblindness. Second, it must represent data without bias. She is a vocal critic of the rainbow color scale widely used in science, pointing out that it distorts data by making your eye jump to certain colors, creating illusions of patterns that are not there. Third, a figure must catch somebody's attention and make them want to know more. She also runs workshops on how to use illustration to communicate research more effectively, both to peers and to the public. Her art is making complex geological data clear, accurate, and understandable. Pérez-Díaz also champions tackling social hurdles, notably through her illustration work on Did This Really Happen? This project turns anonymous submissions of stories of everyday sexism in science from researchers into comics. As she puts it, the goal is to highlight it and let's talk about it and hopefully let's change things. These projects are all part of the same mission. Her entire life's work is about making geology more accessible. She fixes a broken clock to make the data accessible. She draws illustrations to make the concepts accessible, and she fights paywalls and sexism to make the community accessible. Dr. Lucia, the geologist, illustrator, and detective of deep time, believes one of Earth's most stunning novelties is its ability to constantly change its face. She has established herself as one of the most important and creative biographers of that ever-changing face.